Scandal, help me sing it, come on. I'ma get it poppin', don't stop me. No, turning up every weekend, it's a party.
Turn up.
Keep it locked, yeah, you know this. Tune in for the talks, cause this your moment.
It's a happy night show, it's a happy night show. It's a happy night show. It's a happy night show, it's a happy night show. It's a happy night show,
in the building, man.
What's poppin', Talks fam? You can now listen to our show on demand to keep up with our latest shows, some of our favorite moments, and exclusive interviews. Make sure you head over to iHeartRadio, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts.
You wanna do?
Playing nothing but bangers.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Armani.
Hey, this is Cardi B.
What's poppin', Atlanta? Keep the party going all weekend. With Abbie Knights, DJ Rhea, Jenny Ruby, and DJ Cadence on.
What's up? This is Magic Jordan.
This is Drizzy Drake.
I know you've been searching for someone.
The Abbie Knight Show.
Hey everyone, we are back. It's myself, Abbie Knights, and DJ Cadence.
Oh, yeah. What's going on? How you doing today?
I'm good. How you doing?
I'm doing great. I got a lot of stuff to talk about, so we should have a good day today. Good morning, America.
There is a lot to talk about, but listen, before we get started on that, I'm trying to be nosy. How was your Valentine's Day? Did you have a Valentine?
You would get straight into Valentine's Day like that.
Yeah,
my Valentine's Day was cool. I didn't do a whole lot. I just kind of sat and chilled. I watched my Jayhawks win, you know, so, you know, just kind of did that. Just been watching a lot of sports and chilling, so...
You know, that's
Valentine's
not what I was asking. I was trying to find out if you had a Valentine.
Oh, no, it wasn't nothing like that. No, I don't, you know, I don't really do the whole Valentine's thing like that. I feel like, hold on, you can put some soft music in the background. Valentine's Day is every day for me. It's not about one day of the year. It's not about showing love on that one day. It's about showing love every day. And that's what I do. I show love every day, so...
That was very politically correct.
What you do. It's what we're doing. So
I get it. Look, I get it. I get the whole commercialized aspect of Valentine's Day, but I still feel like guys have to understand it's a girl thing. And it doesn't mean that you have to go out and spend like thousands of dollars. Like, you can make it a cute thing between you and your partner, whether you decide to try new things on Valentine's Day or spice things up or maybe cook something different, you know, something. I'm just saying, like, it doesn't have to be like go buy like, you know, 20 dozen roses. You can get creative with it. It's not always about the money factor.
I agree with that 100%. A lot of it is, especially like all my people who've been in like a long relationship. I'm not talking about like 2 years. When you get into like one of them deep, long relationships, you get to the point where you like, I don't even know what to buy anymore. We're already, you know, we're past that anymore. So then you start thinking of really creative things to do. Like, that's when the dinners start happening and the, you know, the little handmade cards and all that type of stuff like that. I think that's really what Valentine's Day is supposed to be about, just showing you appreciate somebody. So
that's it. And I'm not saying I prefer it to be a regular, like something that happens on a regular basis, but on that day, it's kind of like you see everybody, like, you know, posting about it, talking about it. And so I think even if it's something that's not really like a big deal, you're still kind of like, I kind of wish I had something going on. You know what
this
I mean?
This year, I have not seen as many posts this year of all the extravagant things for that their boyfriends was doing. So I don't know, is everybody single this year, or does everybody have little sneaky things going on left and right, or what? But it's like, when I'm looking online this year, I think I've seen maybe two or three people who had the bed was all decked out and the flowers on the ground and all the stuff like that. You know, everybody else, they were just sending regular pictures and stuff. So I'm just wondering. What's going on out there?
People out there, are you single and mingling? You got sneaky links over there? Or are people just not posting as much?
I need to know.
We're trying to find out. We're trying to live through everybody else, because apparently...
Yeah, we're going to be nosy.
Yeah, we're trying. We definitely trying to be nosy. I'm not even going to try and act like I'm not. I am. So a lot going on this week, like you said, Cadence. But first and foremost, I definitely want to talk about major news that just dropped by Louis Vuitton, in case you all didn't know, that Pharrell Williams was named creative director. So that was a big deal because
I didn't even hear that. That's news to me. So that's cool. Well,
listen, one thing Louis Vuitton needs is a fresh set of eyes. They need people to try to keep the creative direction of the brand exciting. And Virgil did that. I mean, he did that by leaps and bounds. And I think Pharrell is a great creative mind. I think his lines do really well. He's been doing it for quite some time now, even though a lot of people don't talk about it. His lines do sell out. Like, hello, I've been trying to get a pair of those Human Race shoes forever. And
those are some dope shoes. I like those shoes a lot. I didn't know he was into the fashion as far as the clothes. He's always been a fashionable person, so it doesn't surprise me. But I didn't know that he was into actually designing stuff like that. So that's dope.
Yeah, Human Race it's a collaboration that he does with Adidas from time to time. And the shoes are really dope. And I joined the little Adidas club since I used to work with them and all that. And every time there's a new shoe dropping, even if I don't like the shoe that much, I'm like, let me just try and see if I get. I never get a pair. Yeah. It's his join lines the sneaker do really heads. Well. Yeah,
that's what happens to all of us. We sit online and, you know, I live in a small, well, not a small town. You know, it's more a little small city. But anytime that we've ever wanted to go out and get J's, you could just go to the mall and pick them up, you know? So it was like, you had to wait in a little bit of line, but it wasn't like, no, you know, you in a line for an hour and a half, nothing like that. You just had to get up in the morning to go pick up shoes. Now everything's online and it's like, I never win shoes anymore. It's so frustrating. It's like, I don't even know what's the point of even trying anymore. So it's bad.
I mean,
need them to get that fixed because I need to buy my shoes. I want my shoes and stuff like that.
I mean, you could get them just at a premium, that's all.
Yeah, I'm not about to pay $400 for a retail pair, $200 pair of shoes. It's just crazy to me. I'm just not going that route.
So, you're not trying to pay for somebody else's bills?
Nah, I'm good. But I do love shoes.
I do love me some shoes too, though, not gonna lie. And well, I like a lot of things. I mean, let me not say it's just that. I like a lot of things. Also, Elon Musk is apparently going to be removing the legacy blue checks on Twitter, which I feel like that was the stupidest idea ever. Is that a word? Stupidest? Dumbest? Whatever.
It is today.
It is now. Okay. That was dumb. Thinking that they weren't going to try to take advantage of that. Like, you just pay and you get a blue check. And then there were people like duplicating accounts, pretending to be other accounts. It was a hot mess. So... Yeah.
It's one of them things where, you know, sometimes people who have a lot of money, they think they know what's going on because everybody around them is always being a yes man to them. So it's always like, yeah, you're great. That's a great idea. That's a great. And let's give credit to Elon. He's done some pretty amazing things, you know,
he has
one of the biggest innovators that we've had in our, you know, generations, the last couple of generations and stuff. But sometimes you're wrong, you know, and this stuff he's doing at Twitter is crazy. And then, like, he's hurting his brand also as far as his name, Elon Musk. It's like a lot of people who looked favorably on him before, now they don't look at him the same way, you know. So sometimes it's better just to stay kind of in the background.
Right. So. I agree. I definitely agree. I don't know if anybody else out there, switching gears a little bit, saw the video of Drake doing his fit check. Where he talked about having a chain. Well, you know, like they've got these TikTok influencers and they'll stop people while they're out and they'll do a fit check. So basically they'll ask, how much does the outfit cost?
Oh, okay. Oh, I'm thinking fit, that. Like get on the ground and do some push-ups or something. That's what I thought you were talking about. Okay,
never mind. What you're talking about. No. So they stopped Drake. I don't know how this dude even got access to Drake like that. He went through the whole look head to toe. But the one thing everybody was talking about was the chain he was wearing that was almost $10 million.
Wow.
I just want to say that's a different kind of tax bracket. Casually walking around with 10 mil on your neck, like,
That's big money right there.
I don't think I would have wanted to disclose that though, if I would have been Drake. I think I would have wanted to keep that to myself because that's a safety risk at this point. But he's got security.
I don't think Drake cares, because Drake's not really one of them flashy people like that. I feel like when he comes out, a lot of times it's like just a regular, you know, he usually does stuff pretty low key. So I could see him kind of saying that just to kind of flex for a little bit, because you don't really see him out like the Migos, the way the Migos used to be, where they was like, you know, 50 chains on their neck and everything like that. You don't ever see Drake really like that. So
at all, yeah. At all. Yeah. But he looked fly. That chain did look expensive. Those diamonds were kind of big. I ain't even going to lie. I'm not going to front.
I like Drake.
The chains are big.
Drake is one of the people that should be getting a lot more props than what he gets right now. You know, facts. He should be getting a lot more props for what he does.
He really should. He really should.
Do you expect him to not have a 10 mil chain on?
Nah, because he's like so understated normally. He might have like a super expensive watch, but he's not really like a super flashy person.
Yeah, I agree.
Kind of like Jay-Z. Jay-Z's not super flashy either.
Mm-hmm. He used to be, but yeah. But I've never seen, you know, Drake was never really on that whole. I mean, he was kind of like a little bit, but he was never really big on the flashy stuff like that. So.
Yeah, I never really saw him doing that. So for me, it was kind of like, you know, I don't know. That was kind of a shocker. But I mean, considering he's a billionaire, it's, you know, I guess it's to be expected. But on to the bigger news this week, Rihanna announced that she was pregnant during her Super Bowl performance. I just want to say I called it. I don't follow football, don't know nothing about football, but I did say I felt like the Chiefs were gonna win. I should have bet on it. The one time I didn't bet, I should have. Cadence, what are your thoughts on this whole football situation? Because, you know,
well, which situation? The Chiefs?
Yeah, I want to know, what are your thoughts on the game, how it played out? By the way, I will say, go ahead. What? Well, go ahead.
No, I'll shout out to the Chiefs. You know, I live in Kansas City land out here. You know, I'm about 2 hours away from KC. So, you know, everybody's Chiefs fans out here. So shout out to the Chiefs. They won their game. They did a good job. Congratulations to them. I see a lot of people talking about that holding penalty. I'm kind of on the same thing right there. I don't think that it should have been called. But at the same time, I still felt like the Chiefs were going to win, even if they would have got that. But it did kind of ruin one of the greatest Super Bowls I think I've ever seen. So it was a good game. It was a good game. I liked it. So especially considering my Bucks wasn't in there. So yeah.
So you were here for it. You're here for the stats.
Yeah. I mean, I was there for the food more than anything. You know, I went to get food more than anything. Rihanna did a pretty good job. I was a little okay. So before, let me put my disclaimer out here. I didn't notice she was pregnant at the time when it first started, but my opinion on it was that I felt like she should have had more energy, you know, like, because when I seen her, she wasn't really dancing, she wasn't moving. I'm a big Rihanna fan. I'm like team Riri over Beyonce, and I felt like when she came out there, she was gonna be jumping around and doing all this stuff, and she wasn't, and that kind of was a letdown to me. So I get why everybody's like, oh, everybody's mad because she's pregnant and they expect her to do all. I just felt like personally, like, I wish I would have known she was pregnant before. So that way I wouldn't have been going into it thinking that she's 100% like somebody who breaks their ankle and then they go out there and they can't walk. Like, I get it, you know, like, I get it. But
you could tell by watching
it. But it was a little lackluster.
You didn't have any idea?
You didn't have any idea? She was rubbing her belly like a lot.
No, I seen it once she was performing, but I mean, it was like you were just watching and it was like, I couldn't tell, was it like, is that still the baby weight? Was that a new baby? You know, like, what was going on? And then I remember Cardi B.
Well,
when I seen Cardi B perform when she was pregnant.
She had more viewers.
I was just going to say 118.7 million viewers tuned in during the Super Bowl halftime performance versus the 113 million that watched the game. That was all the Rihanna fans coming back to support. I felt like the performance was great. I liked what she was wearing. I don't know why people are tripping about it.
So fly.
I thought she looked so good.
I didn't care about what she was wearing. Even if she was,
I cared.
Even if she was, she wasn't pregnant. I mean, I still think that what she wore was cool. I thought it was a good little outfit, you know, so. Yeah,
she
I just wish
she'd
have put more energy into it. But
the
I
vocals
get
were on point, though. The vocals were on point. Nobody can take that from her. The vocals were on point.
The stage looked amazing, too. I thought it looked better than Dr. Dre's stage. You know, everybody liked Dre's stage and all that. I thought that the way they had that set up with the dancers and all that stuff, I thought that was really cool. So
one thing I will say, too, shout out to Paris Goebel. She sure knows how to put a show together. And she had everybody looking really good. I felt like the choreography on that was really, really on point. So I guess shout out to the Chiefs fans. So sorry for Philadelphia. The Eagles had to fly back home, not so happy. And one thing I didn't know is that two of the players were actually related to each other. There were two brothers.
The brothers.
America, this just shows you that Abby has no clue what's going on football-wise. I don't. Like, that was the main talk that everybody was talking about, the Kelsey brothers and stuff.
Yeah.
And
she I didn't even know their name.
See, but she knew Rihanna was coming up. She knew Rihanna was
coming
up.
Sure did. Sure did.
It was a Rihanna concert.
And I was over there jamming out, too. Let somebody try and tame me.
Somebody put a post up I thought was funny, and they was like, you know, why are they playing football before and after the Rihanna concert? You know, I thought that was pretty funny. There's a lot of people who felt like that.
Well, so they did call it the Fenty Bowl, so.
Yeah, there you go. Wait, Abby, so who gave you those flowers for Valentine's Day?
First of all, Jenny, when we started this, you missed the whole beginning. So what did you do on Valentine's Day?
But I know that question wasn't asked.
It was not asked.
Yeah. Damn, Cadence, you couldn't have like covered for me. What did you do on Valentine's Day, Jenny?
What are we doing? Mm-hmm.
What'd you do, Jenny?
Honestly, I didn't do anything.
Wait a minute. No, don't answer that yet, Jenny. Don't answer that. You see how she slid by there? Abby, what did you do?
No, I mean, no, Jen, don't even try and do your little angel face, okay?
This is a devil face.
I had a good Valentine's Day though.
That's good.
She glowing.
No, I'm not.
You see that smile? Ooh,
she's not glowing. She's not glowing. Whoever got it for her, she needs more. She needs more. She's not glowing just yet. More needs to come. It was a little teaser.
Just a little teaser, a small one. Just
I know. You need to lace her up with something else.
Something. I'm just saying, these guys need to get it together. So
yes, house.
Why do those guys got to get stuff together? Hold up. Wait a minute.
I'll see. There we go.
Before you showed up, everything was fine.
No, look at you. Still see the bottom.
What were you going to say, Cadence? Why do the guys need to get it together? Because the guys out here are a hot mess. What? They don't even believe in Valentine's Day anymore. They don't really know how to court women no more. They don't know how to take women on a proper date. I'm just saying.
We agree. Me and Jenny, we get it.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. Let me buy a vowel.
I'm trying to think of a reason why. I don't know. I don't really have an excuse.
No, because they hit you up every other day saying this and that. What are you doing? Let's hang out, blah, blah, blah. But if you didn't get me something on Valentine's Day, all of that was just talk.
Period.
Just saying. Really?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I had this debate with somebody.
But those of you who did, thank you very much. I appreciate it. You're still in
line. But there's the problem right there.
I'm kidding.
If it's one person and I know I'm the only person getting you something, if I feel like you got a bunch of people and I'm in competition, I'm not about to go blow all my money on that. Like,
why are you looking at it like that? It doesn't have to be all your money. You could be the most creative, most thoughtful one.
I guess
it just depends. If you want her, then get her.
That works. until the other person pulls out gets the super bag and all that stuff, and then it's like, oh well, that was nice.
This sounds personal. It has happened before.
Crayon card, you got me.
Yeah, you got something you need to tell us, Cadence.
This has happened before.
No, this ain't never happened before for me because I'm good. You know, I'm good.
Said, I'm good. Here. I'm good. Okay.
I'm
well,
good. I'm the best gift giver. In the relationship, that's usually me. I'm the one who usually gives the best gifts, so I'm always good.
He says he's always good, Jenny. What do you think about that?
I don't know. Maybe. I've never been in a relationship with him, so I don't know.
See, there you go.
I don't know.
There you go.
I don't know.
Think about all my Christmas gifts that I gave you guys.
I don't like when people say that, though.
I'm a very thoughtful person when it comes to gifts, so
yeah.
I pat myself on the back for that.
I don't like when people tell me that, though, and then they come out with something that's like, I don't know. Maybe my expectations are a little too high, but I'm just like, stop telling me that. Like, don't tell me that. And then
I don't tell people.
He's just telling us. He's not telling the people he's with.
Now I'm expecting you to be the best. Now you got to top everyone else. And you just said you were the best. And it's
come
not
out with
the
you the best. You to you.
No, it's like when you just realize that you're talented at something. Like, you know what? I'm good at this. Like, that's
what are you good at?
I feel like I'm a thoughtful person when it comes to gifts. Okay.
What else are you good at, Cadence? Huh?
I'm good at cooking. I'm good at DJing. I'm good at talking deep in microphones. I'm good at that. I mean, I'm good at a lot of things. I'm good at a lot of things. Got to tune into our After Dark special. Find out.
Okay. Did you buy anything for anyone for Valentine's Day? You don't have to say who. I'm not going to pry that hard.
Did I buy anything for Valentine's Day? I bought flowers.
For somebody?
Yeah, I bought flowers.
Cadence had a Valentine.
Mm. It was all right.
I asked him if he had a Valentine. He told me no.
I mean, just because I bought flowers, but it wasn't like I didn't go on no super like horse and carriage thing and all this stuff.
Why do people always make it seem like you have to do all this crazy over the top?
Because you do.
We had to.
That's just for social media. People don't really do that.
I like
real life.
That stuff. I like all that.
I applaud her for being honest. I want it all the time.
I like it all. I like all of it. So it's not just for social media, because if you make it on my social media, if like as a male, that means we're not dealing with each other. As long as you're not on my social media, good.
Well, there you go, fellas. In case
makes sense. I'm all for that one too. I'm all for that one.
Stay private, you know.
I agree for that 100%. Too. You really don't see my personal life on there.
A lot of people are completely opposite about it, but I'm one of those. It's like I feel like social media messes up a lot of relationships. You know, I would prefer to not have my information and stuff like that on social media, like what I'm doing.
I'll post like
and then I get on here and I tell everybody my business, but still, it's all.
I know, right? You know?
Yeah.
There's no tags. You know what I mean? We keep it.
Yeah.
You know.
There you go.
Protect everyone's.
What do they say? No face, no case. So.
Hey.
You know. Just saying. Jenny, you got anything for us today?
That's going to be a no.
I thought Jenny was about to bust out with a crazy list considering it's Valentine's Day week.
I know. I am so... Never mind. Let's not get into that right now.
She was just prying into our business to try to fill in the gap of that. See, she's trying to be like, oh, Cadence, Jenny, what did you do? That's the more important question, Jenny. Who did you do last night?
I didn't do anyone or anything, actually.
I bet.
I honestly, to tell you the truth, I did have plans. Mm. And we were supposed to go out as a group. Mm-hmm. But
because
of this vacation that is taking up my whole life and I'm leaving after work, we all canceled because everyone that was supposed to go is going on the same vacation. So we just decided to just see each other when we get to the other country that we're traveling to. So that's,
So. One thing about Jenny, she stays on a plane.
Stays traveling. Stays traveling.
She really does. No, can't wait to see those pictures. She about to be naked out in them streets.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
What color's your outfit?
My costume this year is gold, purple, pink, metallics. You'll see it on my social media. You'll see me acting crazy for a good week, and then I come back.
Cute. I'm sure you'll be twerking and doing splits everywhere.
It's whining. Whining, not twerking, but yes.
I don't know if you whine or if you twerk or whatever you do once you start drinking and you're down
whining.
There.
When you get to the islands, it's whining. I'm going to be through the streets.
She's going to be in these streets.
With the crew for sure. So,
I hear it's a good time.
It's an amazing time. I would describe it as euphoric. It's fun. It hits all the senses. I love it.
I bet it does.
So every year, we weren't able to go for the past
practically
2 years.
Naked, whining up on everybody, Katie.
Yes.
A few drinks in.
It's so, you feel so free, honestly. The colors, the music. You just kind of just tap into your own world. You don't even know.
Although I will say it's not much different from your typical work outfits. So it's just a little more colorful.
I don't wear those outfits anymore. You know, now I'm very conservative at work. I must be.
Oh, so you left the leather and the chains and stuff at home now?
Mm-mm, those are my waitressing days, girl. I'm not a waitress. I don't waitress anymore. So.
Okay. Yeah. So you saving those for somebody else then?
I wear those. I do mix those into my outfits, though. Like, I wore a body harness the other day on top of my outfit. It looked very professional. I still needed, like, a punch of kink somewhere in there. So I threw in my my body harness over my button-up shirt.
Okay. Nice. That sounds very Jenny right there. Body harness to kink it up. All right. As she gets undressed. Awesome.
Woo! I know. I just came from the gym. So that's why I look like this.
Yeah, like your little biker glasses you got on. You look like you're very ready. You're repping New York City. Cadence is out here repping the right team today. He's all Lakered out.
I'm you repping know. The GOAT.
Purple and gold.
Mr. LeBron James. Let's go. That's what we're talking about.
What about the question?
Oh, we don't have a question today.
What question?
Yeah. Oh. I'll explain why later. Cadence, let's talk about LeBron James making history.
Hey, let's do it.
Let's do it. It's a big deal. Let everybody know what went down during the game.
Hey, my man LeBron once again shows why he is the greatest basketball player of all time. You can argue with your mama, don't argue with me. So I'm really happy that he got this out the way. So now he can focus on playing with his son. So, you know, we can end this chapter, legacy mm-hmm. of the greatest basketball player of all time. But it wasn't a great game because they lost, but it was a great moment in history, you know. Kareem didn't look too happy. I will say that. He looked like he was just like, okay, I'm going to go ahead and give this to you. And then they talked about how, mm-hmm. you know, him and LeBron have had their kind of issues and stuff like that. But, you know, I think that it's great. You know, it shows his longevity. It shows mm-hmm. how hard he's worked. It yeah. shows, you know, just how dedicated he is. And his career, you know, whether, you know, like, you know, LeBron and Jordan and people go back and forth and stuff. But one thing that we can't deny is this man has had a great career from the beginning he walked into the league. And I think that that's amazing when you think that he's been averaging these points for a long time. It'll probably never be done again. And I know people said that about Kareem's record, but it'd be really hard somebody to play 20 years and average 25 points a game, you know, for the next 20 years, you know. So shout out to him. I think that's real dope. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I agree.
So in case anybody out there was wondering who Cadence's favorite player is, we went ahead and clarified that. Round of applause to LeBron James.
Go James. Go James. Let's go. Let's go. I mean, I like Jordan too. You know, I just hate the Jordan arguments that people put up because it's always like, oh, the six championships, as if he only played six seasons, you know, and things like that. And people love to forget that Jordan was a ball hog. Jordan complained about getting fouled all the time. A lot of the things they complain about with LeBron, Jordan had that too. Now, one thing I give Jordan is that killer instinct mentality that he had. And he was the greatest scorer of all time. I'm not gonna take that away mm-hmm. from Michael Jordan. But when it comes to an all-around basketball player, a man who does everything on the court, that's Bron. I don't care what they say. That's Bron. So get that man his flowers.
Period. Well, on that note, it's been a great week for sports. Records are happening. History's happening. I don't have vocabulary Rolling today. Stones. My brain's a little slow.
Let's not forget about the Rolling Stones and their top 50 hip hop artists of all time. You know, like that was a pretty big discussion.
Did anybody out about. There hear Bow Wow's commentary on this? Like basically that he didn't need Rolling Stone to validate great talent because of some executive that pushes a desk.
Bow Wow. Stop it. Ja Rule needs to stop it too. Ja Rule got up there talking about how there ain't 50 rappers dead alive or not alive that dead alive or not born yet that are better than him. I don't know what planet Ja Rule lives on. And we all like Ja Rule's music. He has some good songs. I'm not taking away from Ja Rule on that. But Ja Rule talking about he's one of the 50 greatest rappers of all time is blasphemous. That is completely ridiculous. If you don't find several seats to sit down, because you are not in the top 50, bro. Not at all. I'm sorry. Sit down.
He said blasphemous. It's blasphemous.
That's, I love it.
It's crazy to think that he gets out there. And I don't know why Ja Rule thinks that he is like this.
Yeah, I love the confidence, though. I love the confidence. I love the confidence.
Yeah, I know.
You gotta feel yourself. You have to. In his mind, he's top 50. It's fine.
Yeah.
Maybe not to others, but to him. There you go.
That's fine. You want to have it in your head, but to be out there talking about how it's crazy and all this stuff, like he's trying to act like we had like the Chris Brown situation we had. Like, it's not like that. You know what I mean? It's mm-hmm. nothing like that. Ja Rule, nobody looked at that list and said, ooh, where's Ja Rule? You know, like that was not their first thought. They thought of everybody else. They thought of different placements on there. They thought maybe Kendrick shouldn't have been at number two. That's what I was thinking. Kendrick shouldn't be that high. As much as I like Kendrick, I think he should be a little bit lower. But to be like Ja Rule, come on, bro.
And for those
that didn't have Big Daddy Kane on there.
Right. For those out there that didn't see the list, they did name Jay-Z the greatest rapper of all time. Jay-Z was the number one pick.
I agree with that.
So, and I mean, Jay-Z, you can't compare him to anybody else. He's just, facts. What does everybody say? He's hope.
And he's grown so far. He's come so far from his really first albums all the way to his last stuff and everything. He shows that, and he shows that you can still be relevant in hip hop if you choose to be at an older age. You know, he found a way to stop. Right. Like, he ain't talking about girls. He's not talking about going to the club. He's talking about grown man stuff as he gets older. So I think he showed also that you can progress from doing, you know, the street stuff to being more of a, you know, a businessman. So,
and he did do an interview about that where he said that people needed to change the narrative about it. Like, why it shouldn't be cool to be playing your girl, to not be a family man. Like, that should be the cool thing, you know, to appreciate the person that you're with and take care of your family and all that. So, you know, big shout out to Jay-Z. There's been a lot of really cool things happening. I love the performance that they had at the Grammys. That was everything. It made a major, major statement on such a stage like that, especially when DJ Khaled came out and said they did an 8-minute performance and they didn't even win a Grammy that night, which was mind blowing. I don't know how God didn't win a Grammy either. So I don't know, but maybe it's not for us to know. We're going to take a quick break, but we'll be right back. Make sure you guys don't go anywhere. You're listening to the Abbie Knights Show.
In the building, man.
What's poppin', Talks fam? You can now listen to our show on demand. To keep up with our latest shows, some of our favorite moments, and exclusive interviews,
make sure you head over to iHeartRadio,
Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts.